This week on part two of the search for historical ninjutsu. Who are the so-called modern ninja masters?
As a result of my research, I have now been formally banned from the Bujinkan and the Genbukan for asking questions and for pursuing my lines of research. And I am now known as the heretic.
So my best advice to people who are studying Bujinkan or Genbukan or any other formalized system of martial art is to stop paying dojo dues and enroll perhaps in a good school that teaches you NLP or conversational hypnosis and anything that's going to arm you in the war of wits against your opponent.
We'll also examine the influence of the ninja on everything from films, television.
It's martial arts mayhem.
That's intense, man.
As Adam and Jamie focus once again on the secret world of ninja.
Now, let's find out who's tough enough to become the next ninja warrior.
To cutting-edge science.
This is how a trained ninja fires a blowgun.
And even modern-day crime.
It was either me or him.
He says a loud noise woke him up early Thursday morning. When he went to check it out, he found an intruder dressed like a ninja in his kitchen. Giolo says when he confronted the person, he was attacked with a pair of nunchucks. He fought back, grabbing a nearby kitchen knife and stabbing the person. Yes.
It went all the way into the handle. And he just got up with the handle sticking out of him and ran out of the house.
So join us now for part two of the search for historical ninjutsu, right here on Martial Arts View.
Do ninjas still exist? Do their techniques still exist, and are they passed on in today's society? There is a very simple answer to this question. No one knows. However, there are a selection of people who claim to be descendants of ninja schools and they claim to be teaching historical ninjutsu today. These people have to prove their claims and they have to match themselves with historical ninjutsu for that to be correct. Dr. Hatsumi is regarded as the 34th Grand Master of a ninjutsu art which is called Tokugure. However, the Japanese research community, the ninjutsu research community in Japan, the Iga Ueno Museum, they do not support Masaki Hatsumi and they do not support his school of ninjutsu. Some historians as well edge on the cautious because Dr. Hatsumi's form of ninjutsu does not match with the historical records as he teaches a martial art. For him to be correct, he's got to come forward with his documents. To date, none of his documents have surfaced. He has shown none of them and none of them have been published. There have been media productions such as DVDs and books which shows old documents. However, I've had these checked and none of them at Tokugure or his other schools, they're all well-known, well-documented ninjutsu manuals or other such things. So to date, Dr. Hatsumi has not produced any proof whatsoever. So I'd like to politely ask now, Dr. Hatsumi, I would like access to your scrolls. I would like to catalogue them and I would like to title and date them with the purpose of authenticating them to prove your lineage. I am not saying I disprove your lineage, I'm just saying it's highly improbable. But I would love to be proved wrong and I would love to see the scrolls and we can work together and push ninjutsu forward and get a better understanding of your school. Also, we've got Mr. Kawakami. Now, this gentleman is supported by the Iga Ueno Museum and his ninjutsu seems to be more in line with what's taught historically. However, again, he's come forward without proof, but he has a better claim to his story. So, how do you know if you're really learning ninjutsu? First of all, where you're learning ninjutsu, are you being taught? how to make black powder? Are you taught how to make explosives? Are you being taught how to torture people? Are you being taught how to climb? Are you being taught how to break and enter? Can you do guerrilla warfare, tactics, esoteric magic, ritual magic? All these elements that go into shinobi no jutsu are what are the core disciplines. You have to ask, are you being taught these?
As anyone who tries to proselytize something that they feel is valuable to the public, I have my supporters, and naturally I have, as everyone else does, my detractors. But what I think my detractors fail to remember is that I have trained with each one of the four individuals who are considered masters. Now, I come from Duncan's lineage, and he remains my mentor and, as well as my friend. But I've also studied with Dr. Hatsumi, who I met in 1986, and who actually picked me up at the first Ninja Summit and said, this is my son in America. I trained with Shoto Tanimura, who I found, interestingly enough, moved, taught, and fought very much like my own instructor, Ronald Duncan. I think their backgrounds in law enforcement gave them a very similar perspective. And I found that Tanimura's ninjutsu was very much akin to the ninjutsu that I learned from Ronald Duncan. This year, I had the opportunity to train with Master Kawakami, who incidentally is the only ninjutsu instructor who is acknowledged by the Japanese government as a ninja, a government that disputes the claims of the other Japanese as being the last ninja. And so I found also with Kawakami, who has a Koga heritage, his teachings are very, very close to what I learned starting in 1967. And now we've gone full circle from my learning those things, having been disputed, and now seeing it validated by the person who admittedly is the last Koga ninja.
Many modern teachers today in America and in Japan and all over the world claim that they teach ninjutsu. The question here is, do they really? Firstly, I must say it is okay to practice ninjutsu and reinterpret the skills of the ninja. However, it's different to claim you have a lineage that is unbroken and goes back to at least the high period of the ninjutsu, which was the Sengoku period and before. That is like somebody claiming today they are connected to the Knights Templar who continued after their disbanding. Not impossible, but highly, highly improbable. While it is possible, you need proof of such a thing. You cannot claim it and not back up your claim. If somebody came forward and said they were from the Knights Hospitaller or they were from the Knights Templar, they would have to seriously back up their claims of evidence. But yet there are many people all over the world who claim they come from ninja lines and are being believed, yet do not prove anything. Ninjutsu as a martial art is a modern phenomenon and it can be traced back to the mid-20th century. And you can't really find anything much before that about it being a martial art. I'd like to say, as a result of my research, I have now been formally banned from the Bujinkan and the Genbukan for asking questions and for pursuing my lines of research. And I am now known as the heretic.
So my best advice to people who are studying Bujinkan or Genbukan or any other formalized system of martial art is to stop paying dojo dues and enroll perhaps in a good school that teaches you NLP or conversational hypnosis and anything that's going to arm you in the war of wits against your opponent, because ninjutsu, like all warfare, begins and ends with the mind.
The fighting posture associated with the fire element is Jumonji no Kamae, aggressive, forward-moving action.
Many modern-day shinobi, such as Sensei Stephen Hayes, a ninjutsu practitioner who is well-known, especially in the West, use an elemental construct in their teaching. In this approach, said to be a traditional one, A four or five element system is superimposed upon the work being transmitted.
Before executing a knee strike and takedown.
While Chinese medicine uses the five elements construct for healing, and some martial arts systems, such as Xing Yi Kung Fu, use physical techniques named after fire, water, or metal, for example, is there any evidence that the ninja of old used anything like this in their own training?
From the fire, we learn the power of directed intentions. We can pierce through to attain that which we need.
Well, there's a lot of disagreement, I believe, in terms of the Gokyo or the concept of the five elements with respect to their place in ninjutsu training. I'm of the opinion that that's just recently added. I think it was recently added because it's such a wide field of knowledge that it just adds to your ninja training by a couple of years for you to understand Chinese medical theory and then apply it to all of your life undertakings. My belief is similar to what Jay Glock indicated in Zen Combat, and that's that the five elements were more of a mnemonic, a code by which the ninja could make a parallel to the situation he found himself in and then apply the circle of creation or destruction and thereby find the method. If I may be blunt, it's sort of like you looking at something that arouses you and feeling hot and then taking a cold shower to eliminate that arousal that you're feeling. I don't think it was any more complicated than that, because after all, the ninja, like most samurai, were illiterate. So to try to teach them expanded medical theory is kind of unrealistic.
At this point, it seems fair to conclude that most, if not all, modern ninja practitioners are merely reenactors of sorts, primarily engaged in reimagining what they think the shinobi were, that is, highly trained, black-clad martial arts assassins, as opposed to what most actually were, low-key, skillful infiltration agents who use fighting only as a last resort. The term ninja itself has become, of all things, an extraordinary marketing tool used to brand nearly everything from high-performance motorcycles.
Ninjas versus ninja! Shopping!
To precision-bladed kitchen appliances.
Oh, my kung fu no good.
Crushing!
And with over 1 million ninja kitchen systems sold to date, it's remarkably effective. It's safe to say that the ninja, as a trademark, is now a magnitude above the old high karate aftershave concept.
High karate, aftershave, cologne, and gift sets. High karate, be careful how you use it.
Still, the fascination with the legendary physical prowess, as well as the alleged apparatus of the ninja, has led to, if nothing else, some highly entertaining television.